How's it going, everybody? I'm here in Brooklyn with Luke Rutkowski of We Are Change, and we were just having a live discussion about the media's obsession with Donald Trump. He posted this video clip gif of him stomping on a wrestler at WWE, and it's a CNN head. You know, the CNN logo's on his head. It's got 256,000 retweets right now. And here we are, stuck in this loop, just like the mainstream media, talking about Trump again. But what I want to say is that the media has been obsessed with Trump. We're seeing the Project Veritas videos talking about, you know, CNN saying it's ratings, ratings, ratings. And so I want to have a discussion about the mainstream media because we were hitting on some stuff in the live stream. So, Luke, let me ask you, why is the media so obsessed with Donald Trump? I think we know, but let me hear you say it.
He's a perfect caveat. He's great. He's awesome for business. And there's been a lot of reaction from Donald Trump's latest gif of him,
stomping up
CNN when he was in the WWE. And I think that's brilliant. I think it's great. And all these people out there, all these lefties who are saying, and all these journalists, limousine liberal journalists, who are screaming, oh my God, I can't believe he would do this. He's inciting violence against us. This is horrible. You bet top dollar their producer, their executives are cashing in, and they're cheering, they're high-fiving themselves, because this is great. And if I'm Donald Trump, if I'm doing something illegal, like, say, business with Saudi Arabia, doing really covert stuff inside of Syria, doing really bad, horrible damage to the country of Yemen, this is great for the country not to pay attention to what I actually do, but to pay attention to the distractions.
Let's go from there.
That way, it's great. But then there's also another factor, how this is horrible and how we're more shifting towards a society like Idiocracy, which is just dumbed down, emotional,
The point we need to hit on is what you just said, that I'm in agreement with. CNN is loving this.
Yeah.
Their logo is in this tweet being shared 256,000 times. It's going to be way more by the time this video is up. And they are probably laughing all the way to the bank. Trump, you know, he's showing like I'm stomping on CNN, but CNN just loves the press.
Exactly.
You know, and now we're probably going to see all these journalists use this to produce more Trump content. Trump. And meanwhile, like you said, there's other stuff going on in the world, like Yemen.
Yeah.
So let's not, you know what? We'll talk about Trump. Let's switch this to talking about the mainstream media and the problems they're having. And, you know, one thing I want to add too is like kind of a thread that I've been doing for the past week or so is looking into the media, talking about activist journalism. Ever since I've come off of VidCon and actually saw journalists who were activists on panels talking about fake news, I think we've got some real problems. But now, I think from what Trump has done, one thing we're seeing is that someone from BuzzFeed made another gif where it's Trump getting stomped, but the guy has the DOJ over his head. And so, like, this is our political discourse. We're ignoring the stuff with foreign policy. There's drone strikes. There's civil war in Yemen. There's the Saudi Arabia arms deal. We've got the healthcare bill. Why is the mainstream? You know, I think we know the mainstream media wants ratings, but what can be done?
It's a number of factors, and I say just defeat them by doing their job better. And also understanding the reality of the world that we're living in. It's a hard market out there because you have to, you know, on some levels, the people who thrive in this market are the ones who start fights, are the ones who pin people against each other, and then one side reacts because they get mad, and the other side gangs up together, and now you have double the viewers instead of just speaking the truth.
Are we doing the same thing? Aren't we sitting here criticizing the mainstream media, using their shortcomings to make content? I feel so stupid doing
this. We're punching both ways instead of just methodically one way in order to galvanize a crowd, because I think it's ridiculous what they're all doing. I think it's great on some levels because it's entertainment. It's clicks, it's views. CNN loves this. Donald Trump loves this. It distracts away people from the real issues, and it pushes us forward to a horrible place in society.
We've got the travel ban right now. That just went to effect. Is that what happened recently?
Well, the Supreme Court approved it with some limitations. And it's only still just for 90 days. Only the beginning of a Trump policy.
But this is big news. Of course. We also have the healthcare bill, which is also big news. But what's everyone talking about? They're talking about Trump tweets.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously. And again, like we get trapped in the cyclone too. I will add though, both of us were down covering a protest. So while we were still stuck in the Trump loop, we were actually talking with people on the ground and focusing on things other than what he's tweeting about, you know. But now, you know, we were having the conversation on the live stream, and I'm like, I think, as much as I hate to do it, like you were saying, that people will do a one side versus the other side and then get, you know, use that as fuel. I think there are some aspect to like what we're even doing right now, but at the same time, I'm kind of like, people get their information from these companies, from CNN, from MSNBC, Fox News, and a lot of people don't really know what's going on.
Exactly.
So I think, you know, as much as I don't talk about this all the time, talking about it at least for the past couple of days might be important.
Of course. You have to, you know, it's tempting as independent media, because you could talk about the clickbaity stuff, and you do on some levels. You have to keep your existence. But then I make a concerted effort to actually see what affects people around this world. And one of them is, of course, Yemen. It's one of the biggest, if not the most violent and most humanitarian crisis that's happening right now anywhere in the world. We have over 100,000 people that just got cholera. Thousands of people are getting that disease. Saudi Arabia is bombing their hospitals. The United States is coming in and bombing Houthi rebels. And ultimately, the United States has officially aligned themselves with Al-Qaeda, with Saudi Arabia, in Yemen, bombing the Iranian Houthi rebels. Well, and no one even seems to know the difference between Sunnis and Shiite Muslims. So this problem gets a lot more complex. But as Donald Trump is officially doing this, causing a humanitarian crisis, causing pain and conflict on such a grand scale, where hundreds of thousands of people being affected, it is a disgrace to see everyone just talking about his tweets as being the most offensive thing that happened.
But you know what? I don't blame Trump for the Trump lust. Like, he knows what he's doing, for sure.
Yeah, he's smart.
But it's the media's responsibility to focus on things that are important, to tell us, you know, hey, guys, check out. Look, we just, you know, the U.S. just did a $100 billion arms deal with Saudi Arabia. Is that what it was?
Yeah, around those numbers within a span of 10 years, yes.
Okay. So, look, we're supplying weapons to Saudi Arabia. Is that simple way to say it? And Saudi Arabia is engaged in a bunch of military action, as are we. We need a responsible media that's going to talk about it. So what I will say is, as much as I can even criticize the video we're making right now and what I do, because we're talking about Trump, I'm glad that we're able to use this discussion to bring it back to important things like Yemen, Saudi Arabia, right?
And yeah, it's better than nothing. And what's happening all around this world, because that discussion doesn't happen. You still have the mainstream media, the limousine liberals and lefties all obsessing about Russia, like we saw today when we went down to the protest today. Yep. Everyone's like, he should be impeached for Russia. But when you look at the world stage of events, he's butting heads with Russia militarily, but in such a grand level that it's very dangerous.
But not just that, we went to this protest and we did see a lot of people saying Russia, Russia, Russia. And I'm saying these people, right? The emoluments clause is a much better argument than Russia. The health, healthcare. Yep. These are better arguments as to why you would disagree with Trump over the Russia narrative, because we're not seeing evidence.
Yep.
We're seeing circumstantial maybes, if, but when, and then Comey even saying there's no investigation into Trump and Russia.
And this was artificially created by the mainstream media that made it a spectacle primarily because of their coverage on it, because of their lack of sourcing, because of their anonymous sources, because of them doing not only a piss poor job, but I believe there's malice. I know we could say they're just lazy and dumb, and I think that does contribute to some of it.
I think they're just lazy and dumb.
That does contribute to some of it, yes. But I do think there's also an element of sinisterness when it comes to either being driven by profit or being driven by a bigger purpose. And that's why I think we're seeing billionaires like Jeff Bezos buy up newspapers, buy up media influence at a loss, knowing that they'll lose money, but they'll have control of the people's minds. Zbigniew Brzezinski, Jimmy Carter's national security advisor, top globalist, part of many secret societies, top of the upper echelons, said, you know, soon people will just parrot what they hear on national television.
That's it.
And then his daughter, Mika Brzezinski, said before on live air, we tell people what to think.
This is what they see.
And that's why I think this is a bigger scheme here that is very hard to prove. Again, it's my own personal theory, but I do believe there's a very sinister aspect that does push us to war, that is controlled, that pushes us to benefit the very few.
I think it's more just these arrogant elitists.
I think we're both right on this. And you could say arrogant elitist, but it's very hard to prove your case as well as my case.
Well, but, no, I think mine's a simple solution. Like, Mika Brzezinski is this elitist, and she goes, it's my job to tell people what to think. But that's also interesting, because that wasn't that in the context of Trump?
Yeah.
So I think one thing we're actually seeing is why the media hates Trump so much. Look, first, let me say this. There's absolutely things to criticize Trump on. There's things to criticize any president on, and we should criticize the president. We should criticize our politicians. But the media seems to be, you know, I'll quote John Bonifield when he says it's fair that when Trump says there's a witch hunt, because I really do believe the media doesn't like that Trump goes right around the media with Twitter. Okay.
But at the same time, right over we should all be better people. We should all be better human beings in this society and not react emotionally because someone was a dumbass. Someone was a dumbass, I'm going to be a bigger dumbass. You're a dumbass, I'm going to be a bigger dumbass than
Trump
you.
Tweet.
And that, and that goes all the way down to the individual, especially how you consume your news, especially how you vote with your dollar, especially where you choose to donate to, which independent media organization you choose to donate to, what you choose to view, what you choose to give your energy to. The real things that matter are this catfight that's happening over there in the corner. What matters to you, you decide on the individual level, and you're the one driving this, and you have more power than you believe, and they try to take away your power. They think they have control over you, but in reality, wake up, slap yourself up the head, upside the head, and know that you are in charge.
They're watching. If they're watching, you know, if you guys are watching this channel, I think they're on the right track. But here's what I want to say. Of course I believe in myself. I believe that the videos that I put together, the conversations we have, will help people kind of be more pragmatic and look for more sources. But I will also admit, this job is too big for me, for you, for almost all the indie media. As much as I think a lot of us do a pretty good job, of course, I think I do. I try as hard as I can. I think I'm doing, you know, pretty. I think there's things I could do better. I know that it's just the large media companies are skyscrapers, and I'm like a little shack.
Yeah, I mean,
them, you know,
what do we have? 5 digits of a yearly revenue. Not even revenue, budget.
Like, budget for production.
Yeah. But they have millions.
Tens of millions.
And millions and millions of dollars to run their propaganda. And also deeply connected with the power establishment and the very powerful who they do the bidding for.
So you say propaganda, and I will absolutely flat out say, look, now this news, the president was on a panel about activism, and that's by definition propaganda.
Yeah.
I think a lot of the big companies, you could call it propaganda, but look, at the end of the day, CNN, you know, if we're going to take the O'Keefe videos and this, and we see this office culture that CNN has, if that is how they really are, I wouldn't call it propaganda. I would just call it lazy. It's a lie by omission. It's ratings-driven, profit-driven, hyperbolic garbage.
They're still dumbass buttholes at the end of the day and need to be discredited and need to not be listened to.
Okay, a final thought. Okay, we'll close it up. Why can't people just be honest? Why? What's so hard about being like, you know, we're not always right. We get a lot of things wrong. We try our best. Thank you all so much for watching. You get people like Brian Stelter. And I don't think Brian Stelter's a bad guy. You know, I know Brian Stelter. But he comes out with this statement saying there's anti-journalists. You know, they just want to stop journalism and you know.
They're not doing journalism. They were doing PR for the establishment.
Yeah, but it's not. There aren't people who just want to destroy journalism. People want to know the truth. They just want honest journalism.
Yeah, victimization.
What?
There's
yeah.
a whole victimization yep. culture that people love to do it for attention and clicks, and it's dumb. And I think slowly people are waking up from that. I'm kind of seeing with the comments that I'm seeing from everybody else, like, cut your crap, man up, be a bigger person, be a better person. And I think it begins with all of us. It begins with me, you, and we're not perfect. It takes a lot of introspection, but I hope you guys do it as well.
Yeah. All right, man. Well, thanks for talking, Mr. Luke. Thank you all so much for watching. Luke, we're going to be, you know, I wouldn't say that we ever travel these places specifically together, but Luke and I end up covering a lot of the same things. And
yeah,
that's
we
why.
Don't like each other. We,
no,
we
yeah,
just end up at the same place always.
But we're both going to be in Hamburg for the G20, and there's some other things happening where we'll probably be covering it. So I just want to say thank you all so much for watching. Click the like button if you like the video. Comment below. Let me know what you think. What do you think about this guy? Because Luke's subscribers were calling me names. you can follow me on Twitter at TimCast. Luke is on Twitter at LukeWeAreChange. Luke's YouTube channel is youtube.com/WeAreChange. You can check his stuff out. Make sure to subscribe to my channel. New videos every day at 4 p.m. And if you want to support the work that I'm doing, go to patreon.com/TimCast. Give whatever you'd like or give nothing at all. The videos will always be free and available. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see y'all tomorrow.